is the sound that I'm listening to. I've got goosebumps.
They did their job when they took care of home court, and then they inside job.
We can't stop.
Victory is obviously a life and death situation.
Trying to win, don't care how I do it, just know that I did. I really encourage my haters to talk, throwing that shade on me, keeping me lit.
Anything can happen, especially against the Celtics. Our lucky Irishman is always around the Celtics.
We have to be ready for a battle. Whatever it takes to win, we're going to do.
Here we go with the Brooklyn Nets facing off against the Boston Celtics, as we welcome you to NBA First Round on ABC, presented by Mountain Dew. It's game three of this best of seven series on a beautiful night in Boston. First two games of this series going on in Brooklyn. Here, Robert Williams jersey making an appearance, along with James Harden, as we look at our starting lineups. Starting lineups brought to you by Capital One. And for Brooklyn, the big three, Irving, Durant, and Harden. Blake Griffin and Joe Harris both playing extremely well in game two. They've got an excellent supporting cast all season long. Steve Nash. And for the Celtics, good news, Kemba Walker is playing. He was questionable, had a bone bruise in that left knee, suffered in game two, but he's okay. Jason Tatum had to leave the game after getting poked in the eye. He's okay with Fournier, Smart, and Tristan Thompson. And of course, all eyes centered on Kyrie Irving. As Rachel reported, he got booed when he came out to warm up. Roundly booed when he was introduced in the starting lineup, so no doubt will be booed throughout much of tonight's game. A former Celtic, now with the Brooklyn Nets, who has had a brilliant season, along with his two other star players when they've been healthy. So a huge task for these Boston Celtics, badly outplayed in game two and in the second half of game one. Tatum deflects it, but it goes back to Durant. There's Kyrie Irving's first shot. And they will cheer every misstep for sure, as most arenas do around the country. For the opponent, Walker on the drive, gets inside, layup is good.
That really is the key, and it's been the key for the Boston Celtics team. You put a healthy Jaylen Brown, his Kemba Walker's health and aggressiveness.
James Harden aggressive offense, and he draws the foul, shot's good. And a free throw coming as well.
Cody, we talked about it all year. Kemba Walker healthy for this Celtics team. They're a different team to defend.
And there's no question. I think most people understand he's been a little bit diminished quickness-wise because of the knee issue. But that doesn't prevent him from being a dynamic offensive talent. And I think he's one of the great leaders that people don't understand. His infectious spirit brings about better chemistry.
Drives inside. Layup reverse won't go. Tristan Thompson still misses. First, Kemba Walker missed 29 games in the regular season with knee problems. Joe Harris knocks down a three. How about the start from Harris in game two? He had 16 of his 29 in the first quarter in Brooklyn the other night.
Mike, I think he's so important to the Nets. I think he's part of the big four. I think he's that important.
Thompson, the offensive rebound. And then barrels in and gets a call for an offensive foul.
Well, he's so lethal, Joe Harris is, in transition. Kyrie Irving, excellent job pushing it, advancing it. Harris, catch and shoot, automatic.
Well, Thompson picks up the personal there. Harden comes the other way. Well, the Celtics have talked about the last couple of days that they need to be more physical. That was a big message. Marcus Smart leading the charge. Brad Stevens telling us that earlier today as Durant fires up a three. And the long distance dialing in early for the Brooklyn Nets. Smart's been been their leading scorer through the first two games, obviously with Tatum missing a good portion of game two. Kemba Walker can't connect. And a loose ball foul will go against Brooklyn. And throw Harris and Griffin converging. This one's on Harris.
That's terrific effort by Tristan Thompson to pound the offensive glass.
Smart left open. He shot well from three so far. 50% from downtown through the first couple of games. They will lead one of those games where they really shoot the ball well. Harden drives past Fournier, gets inside. No help and an easy bucket for Harden. Fournier quickly down the other end. Shot blocked. Grant, but he got shaken up. Got hit in the face. And a goaltending call on the second shot opportunity. But Kevin Durant is hurt. Ironically, it was Durant the other day, Mark, who inadvertently poked Jason Tatum in the eye, made him lead the game. That was his own man.
And Fournier got hit on top of the head, too. He has a complaint. Everybody's got a complaint.
Fournier picks up the personal. There's three quick fouls on the Celtics, first on Fournier.
And just look at the pressure that this Nets offense puts on every possession. You got three guys that can score with basically anybody that's ever played the game, and then you have Joe Harris who can shoot, and a big and Blake Griffin who can do some things also. It's just tough to defend.
And they're just isolated. They're just, I'm better than you, I'm gonna take you, and then make the right play. It's nothing complicated.
And that's the problem sometimes as coaches, you wanna make it too complicated instead of realizing, I got the baddest dudes on the floor, let me put them in position, now do you.
Well, Steve Nash is, likes the way they're coming along at both ends of the floor, likes the unselfish play, likes now the commitment to